Hello, and welcome back to Dead Space. Now that we're about halfway through the game, we're gonna take a quick look at a couple things. As you can see, if we mess around with the right analog stick, we can jostle around the camera and see what's just outside of our periphery. There's a few images from the game and stuff like that. But more interestingly, we can see some runes and markings, and they should look a little bit familiar. We've actually been coming across graffiti and scrawlings on the Ishimura that seem to be made of these markings. We passed by a cipher for this unitologist's scribbling back in Chapter 6. It is a little bit smudged, though. So here's a slightly easier to read one that I found. So with that in hand, if you feel like it, you can pretty much decipher any piece of graffiti that we pass by, assuming that it's not smudged beyond recognition like a lot of them are. There's also a few instances of, Unitology script being hidden on flickering screens and monitors, so make sure to keep your eye out. The other thing I'm going to show off real quick is just a little Easter egg, sort of strange. If you scroll quickly through the menus, this will happen. Yeah, it starts playing chase music for some reason. The comms array is acting up, and we have a job to do.
Things are looking up. A military ship just docked in. The USM Valor. I don't know what it was doing out there. It must have gotten our distress signal. We can't talk to it until the comms array is fixed. I'm gonna hack the door to communications for you. Get in there and find the comms control station.
Quick return trip to the bridge. Hopefully there aren't too many surprises waiting for us. That's probably asking for too much, though. We're gonna replace the contact beam with the hydrazine torch for the time being. We'll see how that works out. Thank you. Usually it's not the best idea to buy a new weapon this late into a hard mode playthrough, especially a weapon that you unlocked really early on, in like Chapter 2. It's beginning attack and stats just can't really do much for you. But we're doing it anyways. We'll put a couple power nodes into it and hope that it works out. Oh, that's disgusting. The bridge has definitely gotten a little bit worse since we were last here. I do not anticipate this going well. You've already seen me loot this room before, and I spend the next minute or so just kind of jogging around it, making sure I didn't miss anything, so I'll spare you that. I also took the liberty to buy another power node really quick. We're gonna open up the flamethrower and see what we can do with it. Oh. Not much, actually. That's kind of a shame. Most of the good upgrades that we actually want are a little bit further along in the power node grid than we can get. All we can do is capacity for now. Oh well. After some deliberation, I decided on a point of speed for the force gun and that capacity upgrade for the flamethrower. I do want to upgrade it a little bit, so it's useful. So we have to start somewhere. We could try to go down to the room where we met Hammond before, but the elevator would just be deactivated, so no real point.
Isaac, the door to communications is open. But I've been getting some weird feedback spikes on the local comms. I think someone's listening in on us, so be careful.
Oh, goody. We don't have much line gun ammo. Let's try the force gun on these guys. Well, that was embarrassing. Terrible dodging skills aside, the Force Gun actually works pretty well against the Guardians. But you don't want to use it too much. Getting close to them is not a good idea. Oh, hey, Survivor! Hey, man, are you... Whatever that thing was, it was horrible, and I hope we never see another one again. As you saw, the flamethrower, the vanilla flamethrower at least, does not do much damage. We're gonna have to upgrade it a bit before we can really make use of it.
Communications log. First comms operator Bailey reporting. The ship is under attack, but requests to issue a distress call have been repeatedly denied by Captain Matthias. He won't say it, but everyone on the bridge knows why. This is an illegal operation in a prohibited system. We've all known for months, and we kept our mouths shut. Not anymore.
Mayday! 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 This is USG Ishimura!
What the hell? I don't believe this. The whole comm system is offline. Now he's gone too far. Bailey out.
Oh, it would seem that the big space corporation was doing something illegal and or questionable on some level. Go figure. That was certainly spooky.
Communications array offline. A service technician has been notified.
That comms array is in bad shape. We need at least 6 working dishes for a strong enough signal. Make sure they're aligned symmetrically, so there are no power gaps.
No, thank you. I think we'll be okay. Well, we can always use more power nodes. As we've gained more weapons, our power node supply has kind of dwindled. I wonder if there's an easy way to get more.
Entering zero gravity.
The necromorph's gone, this place is actually sort of nice and atmospheric. We just kind of take our time and get this little menial engineering task out of the way. It's a simple little puzzle. You just have to get all the working array parts together in a perfect circle. No shortcuts here. I really like how peaceful it is in here after you solve the puzzle. It's really nice. Kind of reminds me of the save rooms in Resident Evil games. It's always like the one area with nice, peaceful music. It'd be nice if this game had things like that. If you're an idiot like me, it's pretty easy to, occasionally, when you're playing through this game, walk right past your objective here, jump on the tram, and have to ride it all the way back when you figure out you walked right past your objective.
This is USM Valor, widecasting on all frequencies to USG Ishimura in response to your SOS. We've picked up your escape pod, number 47, and are en route to your position. This message will repeat every 30 seconds until you respond.
What? Isn't that the escape pod Hammond jettisoned? One of those things was on board. No! No, this isn't going to happen. USM Valor! Come in, Valor! Our signal isn't strong enough. I'm going to open the blast doors to boost the signal.
Error. Blast door blockage detected. Please contact a repair technician.
Shit! Isaac! There's something big on the hull of the ship, directly above the comms array. Something organic. I don't know what it is, and I don't care. We have to get the doors open to transmit to the Valor. You should have a clear shot from ADS Cannon 48. Get to the cannon and blow it out into space.
It just keeps getting weirder now that I know how to use elevators. When did that happen? I thought this body was not here before, but no, it was. I just didn't notice it. Yet another weird little thing. That box just kind of opens when you walk near it. I guess it's just busted. Hey there, you mind, getting off the ship? Hey, wake up. So here's another boss fight, I guess you could call it. It's pretty simple. You just shoot the yellow bits and shoot the debris that it throws at you. That's about it. I would not call this as interesting or exciting as the Leviathan boss fight. But it's an excuse to reuse the ADS cannon mechanic that they brought up for the asteroid sequence. This is a lot easier than that asteroid sequence, by the way. It's relatively trivial to get through it without really getting hit by anything. At least that's how I remember it. In my normal mode practice run for this chapter, I got completely dunked on by this stupid slug boss. He got me down to like 20% hull integrity. I don't know why. Just really bad at video games. About there.
Opening communications array blast doors.
Kendra Daniels on the USG Ishimura, come in. Do not open the escape pod. USM Valor, this is Kendra Daniels on the USG Ishimura, come in. Do not open the escape pod. Damn it, respond! Why did they open the pod? Damn it. Oh my god. It's headed right for us. Isaac! Get the fuck out of there!
I wish I could just talk to someone. It's all falling apart here.
Isaac, are you there? Thank God you're all right. I've been trying to reach you. Someone's been blocking my rig signal remotely. A crash must have interrupted the signal block.
Hammond, where have you been?
Surviving. Barely. I found some med supplies and packed myself up. Listen, I'm calling abort on the mission. Fuck the CEC and fuck the chain of command. We have to get the hell out of here. I think I've located a shuttle on the crew deck. Flight log says it needs a new singularity core, but we can probably salvage one from the Valor. I can see the tail end of it sticking out from the side of Ishimura. I'm headed down there now to find a way inside. I'll meet you there. Hammond out.
Isaac, if what he says is true about the shuttle, we might have a chance of getting out of here. Head to the cargo bay and see if you can help Hammond. In his condition, he may not last long.
Okay, well, that didn't entirely work out, but the Valor crashing into the Ishimura might be a blessing in disguise. If we can salvage that core, we might still have a shot. things are a real nuisance. That's better. The secondary fire for the flamethrower there. It just sets some flames on the surface you fire it at, and anything that walks in them will be hurt. Well, that should help a bit. Still not quite up to our standards, but it's a start. Cleanse this ship with our holy flames. Next time around, we're going to investigate the crashed USM Valor, in the hopes of salvaging what we need to escape from this horrible, stupid ship. Until then, I'll leave you with Isaac's commentary, and a small bonus after the video is done. Have yourselves a great night.